I've been in the last few days in a place called Al-Ahsa. It's also known as Hajar. And in the time of the Prophet wasallam, this entire area was known as Al-Bahrain. My beloved, subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam firstly said that from Makkah till Hajar would be the size of one door of Jannah. Furthermore, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam's seerah ties very greatly to this place. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there was the clan by the name of Abd Qais, and they came with their leader to Madinatul Munawwara. As they were approaching Madinatul Munawwara, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu that some people are coming from the north. They are coming from a place called Hajar. وَهُمْ خَيْرُ مَشْرِقِ الْأَرْضِ. They are the best of the people from that area. In one narration, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Hum ahsanul Arab." They are one of the best clans of the Arabs. So then Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu became very excited. And subhanallah, he ran out to the outskirts of Madinatul Munawwara upon a camel in order to meet these people. When they arrived, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab basharahum, he gave them the glad tidings of what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said regarding them. They became so infatuated and overwhelmed with the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that they left their camels on the outskirts of Madinatul Munawwara and they began running to the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam barefooted. And as they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's masjid, the Sahaba draw the scene that they began kissing the hands and the face of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam out of love. They sat down, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked them, "Where is your leader?" They said, "He is still coming." And he came later on. He was Abd al-Qais. And subhanallah, he had a big scar on his forehead because when he was young, a donkey kicked him on his head. So subhanallah, with a deep scar, he came into the masjid. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw the scar on his face and called him Ashaj. And hence we know him famously as Ashaj ibn al-Qais. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam seated him next to him and asked, "Why did you take so long to come?" And he said, "Ya Rasulullah, I thought we came from a long safar and to meet you, I want to make it special. So I went to clean my clothes and subhanallah, take a ghusl and come to you in a manner of etiquette." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam smiled and said, "Innaka rajul, you are a man, fika khaslatain, you have two qualities that Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam loves, al-hilm wal-anat. You are very tolerant and you do things slowly but properly and perfectly." My beloveds, this was the starting of these people here from this place where we are right now, called Al-Ahsa, or known as Al-Hufuf, or known as in the olden days as Bahrain. Today's Bahrain is just a small little island. That time, that was not even Bahrain. Rather, Bahrain was an entire area that stretched from the north right up to the Arub al-Khali, what we know as going up to Yemen. My beloved, subhanallah, these people came with great fervor and love to meet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave them over to the Ansar and said to the Ansar, "Innahum amthalukum." These people are just like you in land, in color, and in looks. Take care of them. Ghayra khazaya wala nadama. They are a nation that, alhamdulillah, there'll be no loss and there'll be no regret with them or around them. The Sahaba took care of them during the evening. And the next day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Teach your brothers the deen." There were small halaqat in the masjid. And the Abd al-Qais were there learning surahs of the Quran al-Kareem from the Ansar. When they came, Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Hal ma'akum min azwadikum shay'a." Do you have something from your provisions? And they took out some dates. And Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam looked at those dates. And it was known as Raziz. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam named it Barni. And he even said, "The best of your dates is the Barni date." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The Barni is a shifa." So subhanallah, Allah blessed this nation so much. Today we were driving through the oasis. It is one of the biggest oases of date palms, subhanallah, in the entire kingdom. And not only that, I was told by some of the Bedouins sitting in the tent and explaining to me about camels and about date palms. Subhanallah, that you can bring any date palm from any part of the world and plant it here, it will grow. That is why it is mentioned that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a choice to where he wants to make hijrah to, he gave him a choice between Madinatul Munawwara and Al-Hajar, which is this place, ya alhamdulillah. My beloved, subhanallah, this place from the oldest of civilizations, there were in the time of the Jahiliyyah, there were so many poets here. Imru'ul Qais, the famous Imru'ul Qais, was also here. And they would sit here and they would say great poetry. And it was a land of tamaddun, a land of ilm, a land of knowledge. And today, some of the greatest oil reserves and gas reserves are in this area. Definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted it a lot of barakah. But what's exciting, again, subhanallah, these sahaba, after learning by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they then came back here. So Abdul Qais and the sahaba with him. Masjid al-Juwatha is a special masjid. It is here where the sahaba returned from Madinatul Munawwara. They established this masjid in this place. And subhanallah, and this is where the second Jum'ah of Salah took place in the seventh year of Hijrah in the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And subhanallah, the sahaba lived in this area. And near the grave, not only that, but subhanallah, near the masjid are graveyards filled with the qubur and the graves of sahaba, legends like Sayyidina Thumama bin Uthal radiallahu ta'ala anhu. My beloved, subhanallah, the money that came from this area to Madinatul Munawwara was untold. Because, subhanallah, the sahaba gave their zakat in plentiful. And those Nasara and Jews that were living in this area paid the taxes. My beloved, subhanallah, it comes in Sahih al-Bukhari. Then one morning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was performing his Salatul Fajr. And sahaba from all the smaller masjids heard that some wealth came from Bahrain. It came from this area, from Juwatha, from Al-Ahsa. And subhanallah, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man faqru akhsha alaykum. Oh my sahaba, I think you heard that Abu Ubaidah brought the monies that came from, subhanallah, Bahrain. Should I tell you something? I don't fear poverty over you. But what I fear is that you given too much wealth and you begin competing in it like those before you, hence it destroys you. My beloved, subhanallah, in the time of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he placed Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the famous narrator of hadith, here in this place called Al-Ahsa, Hajar, or you want to say Juwatha, or the greater Bahrain. And subhanallah, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu led the people, guided the people. And subhanallah, one day he took so much wealth from here. And he goes to Madinatul Munawwara. And when he comes to Medina, he meets Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. And he says, I brought 500,000 gold coins. And Umar said, what? How much is that? They were ummi. They were unlatted. So Umar radiallahu anhu said, how much? So he said, 10,000, thumma 10,000, like this, like this, like this. And he went on. And Umar was like dazzled. And then salah time came. And Umar ibn al-Khattab performed the salah. And after the salah, subhanallah, he said, Abu Huraira, come here. You're telling me something. Can you repeat? Abu Huraira said, I told you. Umar said, salah time comes. I cut off. I completely deleted everything from my mind. Focused on my salah. Now you may, subhanallah, return to tell me how much you brought. My beloved, subhanallah, sahaba's miracles were displayed in these lands. Ala al-Hadrami radiallahu ta'ala anhu came. There was no water. He made dua, Allah Ta'ala made rain come in this area. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them drinking water. Not far from here, there was a small island called Darin. When they were surrounded and Ala al-Hadrami came, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said that subhanallah, they chased the enemy. When the enemy got onto the boats and sailed across onto the island, subhanallah, Ala al-Hadrami told his army, let us move forth. and on the backs of horses they crossed the ocean. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it, and that's why the poet says that when the Sahaba of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam wanted to cross the ocean, Allah opened the ocean for them and they passed on the dry land. But when the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam needed to pass, they passed over the water itself. My beloved, subhanallah, we learn, Allahu Akbar, this place is so blessed that Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi says that when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam passed away, then there were many of the clans of the Arabs that turned renegade and they went against Islam. But if there was one place in entirety after Makkah and Medina that not even one person went against his deen, it was this place called Al-Ahsa, this place called Juwatha, this place called the Greater Bahrain, where subhanallah the Sahaba, a man by the name of Jarud, he was a Nasrani. He came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ninth year of Hijrah. He accepted Islam. He came back here. When the Prophet passed away, he stood up and he said, "O people, did Isa not pass away? Did Musa not pass away? So by them passing away, did their religion die out? So why is it that when Nabi Kareem Muhammad Rasulullah passes away, then we start having doubts? His religion is pristine, pure and clean, and we need to continue." MashaAllah, this is a beautiful place because it still retains ilm and knowledge with heritage and lineage. SubhanAllah, there are, subhanAllah, sons of Sahaba here. We met yesterday the Banu Hashim, the Banu Hashim tribe that, subhanAllah, are the direct descendants of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they know their lineage right up to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. These are people of karam, hospitality. They have, you know, subhanAllah, thrown out their hearts with love to us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them. They are people of Ahlul Ilm. There's a Mufti in the Shafi'i Madhab, a Mufti in the Hanbali Madhab, Mufti in the Hanafi Madhab, Mufti in the Maliki Madhab. There's entire families that are protective over the Madahib here in Saudi Arabia, subhanAllah, and they follow it very closely. And subhanAllah, there are hundreds of Talaba and students of deen that I hear that learns, mashallah, under the tutelage. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the love of the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.